Morning, my name's Roger Armstrong. I work for the Department of Economic Development. I'm based at Horsham in Victoria. What I want to report about today is some recent results from a Department of Agriculture and GRDC funded project looking at nitrogen management in the higher rainfall areas of southern Australia. What we've found in the project and with my two colleagues, Dr. Rob Harris and Mr. Ash Wallace, is that in the higher rainfall zone areas such as around Hamilton, when nitrogen fertiliser is applied at sowing, we're finding losses of up to 85% of that nitrogen. So to how we've assessed that nitrogen loss is using 15N labelled fertiliser, it's applied as would normal fertiliser. So those losses appear to be via denitrification, so they're lost to the atmosphere and unavailable to the crop. Similarly, when we look at areas such as the Wimmera, so much lower rainfall but also much lower background soil total nitrogen and carbon, we've recorded losses over the last 3 years ranging from around about 20 to 25% up to 45% of the nitrogen applied at sowing. Conversely, when we look at losses of nitrogen, in this case it's urea, at top dressing in the higher rainfall areas such as Hamilton, those losses are significantly decreased, but they're still of the order around about 40%. Conversely, when we look in the Wimmera, urea top dress at mid-till, we recorded losses of around 20%. As part of this work, we've also investigated whether the use of inhibitors such as nitrification inhibitors or urease inhibitors for top dress urea have any effect. What we found is in the higher rainfall areas that the nitrification inhibitor can significantly reduce emissions of greenhouse gases such as nitrous oxide and has a small but significant effect on in reducing the losses of fertiliser nitrogen. But in the Wimmera, those effects are so marginal as to be not significant. I think the key message for growers there is when you're doing your nitrogen budgets, you need to account for those potential losses. But most importantly, in both whether it's in the Wimmera or the higher rainfall zone, really get to know how much background nitrogen you've got in the system. So in around Hamilton, what Rob's found is often he's recording mineral nitrogens prior to sowing anywhere between about 120 and 300 kilograms of nitrate per hectare. And as a result of that, he's not getting any significant grain yield responses to applied nitrogen. So the message is save your hip pocket, do the soil testing, and save on significant expenses of fertilizing nitrogen. Conversely, in the Wimmera, where we've found regular responses to urea, again, similar message, measure how much mineral N you've got in the profile prior to sowing, and also take account of your soil water at sowing and the seasonal forecast, and then make a judgment on that basis.